Welcome to the Whiskey Jug, the only whiskey show on the internet that has seen every episode of 30 Rock twice. And today, we are going to be doing the last glass review of the Jim Beam Devil's Cut. So now, if you're not familiar with the Jim Beam Devil's Cut, they take their traditional bourbon, stuff that you find in like the white label and even down the road in the black label, and after they dump the barrels, they fill the barrels back up with water, put them in kind of a kiln-like situation where they've got a lot of heat, and then they agitate them. And what that does is that forces the water deep into the barrels and back out, and it pulls all the rest of that, the bourbon flavor that's gotten absorbed into the barrel, but it also pulls with it a lot of woody flavors with it, which is why this tastes so woody. A lot of people seem to like it because it does have a flavor that is a little bit closer to some of the older bourbons. Something, when you're drinking stuff like the Barter House stuff, where it's a 20 plus year bourbon, anything like the Elijah Craig 23s, 21s, any of the old Pappies 20, 23, when that kind of really oak-driven, oak-heavy, woody flavor profile, that's basically what they're trying to mimic here. And it doesn't come off quite as natural as it does in those. And that's really one of my biggest complaints. But before we get into all of that mess, let's give this a go, shall we? So the nose is definitely, I mean, it smells like a wood shop. It's very, very heavy on the oak. There's a lot of caramel in there, dark fruit, spice, some molasses, toffee, toasted nuts, really dark, sweet flavors, a little bit of spice in there, some cinnamon. So it's a really dark, dark bourbon. So a lot of dark sweetness, dark spices, dark notes, and it's really wood driven. Let's go to taste. On the palate, again, that wood character is really, really strong. A little bit of caramel, some cinnamon, slightly nutty, some good dark fruit, like cherry, strawberries, kind of a little bit more of like the dried variety in there now. Vanilla, a little bit of that yeasty Jim Beam character that comes along with them. On the finish, again, it's very a wood-driven finish. Some caramel, leather, cinnamon. Yeah, a little bit of raw, like cane sugar happening there too. So, really interesting stuff. Now, when I first wrote the review, which, as always, the link to will be in the description or above if you're watching on the site, and I said that on the palate, that the caramel and the vanilla, or sorry, not the caramel and vanilla, the caramel and the wood were battling it out for dominance. One of them was trying to get there. They were both very, very strong, but over the course of having drank this, the wood has definitely conquered. That's for sure. Now, by the end here, it's incredibly, incredibly wood-driven, which isn't a terrible thing. Some of that astringency that was first in there has died off, looking back through my notes. About a quarter of the bottle, a lot of that kind of evaporated, blew off. And so the last rest of the bottle, it got a little bit sweeter. There were a little bit more complexities started to come out, and a little bit more, and that wood just got a little bit richer, but it still has this weird sense to it. When you have a lot of the older bourbons that are very heavily oak, the spices, the sweet notes, everything that comes along with it is a lot richer, rounder. This stuff, the sweet note that didn't really come out with the wood when they put it through that process, those notes, they're not quite as rich. They still feel a little young, they still feel a little flighty. So you have this duality happening of this really rich wood character and these really young, flighty kind of spices and savory and sweet notes mixing with it. That, to me, it still feels off balance. It doesn't feel like there's a good harmony happening in this whiskey. However, things have changed enough in it, and I grew to like it a little bit more while drinking it, enough that I've settled on a final score of 78. Now, I originally gave it a 77, so gone up by 1 point on it to bring it up to a 78, and that's going to be its final resting score. So with that, this is the Whiskey Jug. I'm Josh. Cheers.